Hi, everybody. Welcome to Demo, the show where companies show us their latest products and services. I'm here with Jeff Monday. He is the Vice President of Global Enterprise and Channel Sales at Qualcomm. Jeff, welcome to the show.
Hey, Keith. Thanks for having me.
And you might notice that we're in a different studio. This is Qualcomm headquarters in San Diego, so thank you for having us here.
Hey, thanks for coming.
All right, so you're going to show us something really awesome because we flew all the way out here to do this.
Absolutely. Full disclosure, I'm not a coder. I just play one on TV.
Okay. But
definitely going to walk you through a code generation demo today, leveraging AI at the edge. So not in the cloud, but on device.
And there's a special chip that does this, right?
There is. It's called the NPU. It's a neural processing unit.
Yep.
It's been built and optimized for AI workloads, and it's a unique part of the Snapdragon architecture.
Okay, so for people who are unfamiliar with what an NPU is, tell me the differences between obviously a CPU, a GPU, and now we've got NPUs.
Yeah, lots of use. but the CPU is your computational processing. So it handles most of the computer-related work. Then you've got your GPU, which is your graphics processing unit, and then you've got a neural processing unit. You'll see some AI workloads can function on a GPU, but they are actually best on an NPU when that AI workload is optimized for that NPU.
Right, a lot of the early artificial intelligence stuff was being offloaded onto the GPU, correct? And now they decided, well, let's put it on its own little processing unit.
It's exactly right. And the pace is just incredible,
right?
Like when you take a look, I'm going to show you a demo today where that model 3 years ago was in the cloud.
Was
a cloud class, multiple GPUs running in an enterprise server farm to be able to process it, now can actually run completely disconnected on your device.
Right. And so what are the benefits now having that NPU on the device versus maybe something that doesn't have that and you're then either contacting the cloud for a lot of your AI work or you're offloading it onto the GPU?
Yeah, I think you know what you're seeing is now that the NPU is in market, ISVs are taking advantage of this. Software developers are taking advantage of this and seeing new ways that they can deliver experiences. We're going to show code generation, but there's plenty of others. There's image generation, there's speech recognition, so you can do real live translation on the device. But more importantly, Microsoft is actually taking this as part of their Copilot Plus.
Okay.
Not Copilot, Copilot's in the cloud. Copilot Plus suite are features that are going to live on device, which means you can use them in a disconnected state. Things like semantic search, recall, click to do, all actually are coming first on Snapdragon. We're Microsoft's innovation partner when it comes to putting AI on the PC, and you're going to see all of those features first and best on Snapdragon.
All right, and so for this particular demo, this is really designed for who within the company?
Yeah, so I'm going to show a code gen. So this is for coders and developers, but you know that's probably the first order of people that will be affected by this. We actually deployed a bunch of these devices out to Citibank because their CIO saw as they were bringing AI workloads into the enterprise, they were causing a lot of cluttering of their GPUs in the data center, and they wanted to bring those AI workloads down to the edge. And by doing that, they were able to declutter their GPUs and actually drive some really interesting effects. So when AI sits at the edge, you don't have the latency issue of it going up to the cloud. It's hyper efficient, it's secure, and it's private. And that was the big thing for Citi is they didn't want the code leaving the device. They wanted the developer to be able to do all their code gen on device without it ever having to leave the cloud. And so that created a really secure private environment.
And I think you just answered my other two questions in terms of what problems you're solving, why should people want this on their device versus going to the cloud, and then what would they be doing without this?
Yeah. I mean, I think that, again, the NPU is ushering in a whole new class of experiences. So as an example, I'll give you one more before we go into the code gen. Probably my favorite is, as we're working with the ISV community, you take a great PC. So this is the Lenovo T14S. It's got the Snapdragon processor. It gets 22 hours of battery life plus in the open environment.
Yeah.
But then IT puts its stack on it, right? and now you've got endpoint protection running in the background. You got a bunch of stuff. That's all eating up CPU and GPU cycles in the background, and it affects your battery life. And so kind of the open secret in the enterprise is that you get this great 20-hour PC, IT puts its stack on it, and now it only gets 4 to 6 hours. What we're doing is we're actively working with a lot of these large endpoint protection providers to move those workloads onto the NPU where they're far more efficient. So you're going to take this great 22-hour PC, IT's going to put its stack with NPU-enabled features on it, and now it's going to get 22 hours of battery life in the enterprise. pretty awesome.
Nice. For those people that work 22 hours a day.
Yes. Most people at Qualcomm.
Yeah, yeah. All right, so let's jump into the demo and see what you got.
Perfect. Okay, cool. So again, playing a coder on TV here. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to open up Visual Studio, which is, you know, common coding platform.
Yep.
We've done a lot of work with Microsoft to be able to integrate and have them optimize Visual Studio for our NPU. And I'm going to open up here the Qualcomm AI runtime environment. This is basically a code gen assistant that we use here at Qualcomm.
Okay.
We have over 1,500 engineers that have deployed this. They've written millions of lines of code. What's great about it is you can actually take an open source model. So I'm going to use a LLaMA 3, which is an 8 billion parameter model. As okay. I mentioned, like 3 years ago, that was a cloud class model. Now it's running at the edge here.
Right.
I'm gonna start to generate that. And what's cool about this is it's not just, we're going to show code gen today, but we've got a code refactor, which helps you optimize your code. We've got a testing agent, and then we've got a code debugger. These are all leveraging, again, the NPU capabilities and built on this LLaMA 3 model. So I'll do my code generation. I'll start the model here. While that's firing up, I'm going to do two things. I'm going to open up the task manager. I'm doing this just so you can actually see how the NPU is being utilized here. So we'll jump here. You can see here's CPU, here's memory. We talked about some of those. Here's the NPU. So let's check this chart. Just by starting the model, you can start to see that the NPU is starting to fire. But we're actually going to give it a workload to be able to process. So I'm going to open up my Python prompt here.
And what prompt are we actually asking it to do?
Yeah, I'll show you real quick here. So basically, I'm asking it to generate a Python script that takes a look at an Excel file. So this is actually a real-world use case that we use to take a look at market share. We get these big files from our third-party market data providers, and we've got to figure out how to process them and get them into a form where we can actually infer the insights, right? So this cleans the data. It analyzes the data to find a correlation between two columns, and then it visualizes the results, right? So again, this is a pretty big ask for me, but when I pass it to my developer, they look at it and like, this is pretty mundane, right?
This
isn't the most exciting code that they could be writing today, but they're going to do it, right? And so now we can actually make their lives much easier. So I'm going to start a new file here. Just do a basic text file here within Visual Studio. And I'll paste, enter. And then right now, I'm going to have it generate, right? So while that's generating, you're going to see it start to move.
Okay. Wow, cool.
And you'll see the NPU starting to fire. Yep. Again, so none of this code is leading the device. None of it's going up to the cloud. It's all being generated here, secure, private, very low latency, right? So while that's generating, we'll flip back. You can see it's still in this light gray generating that code. And again, it's... you can imagine as a coder, you'd have to type all these lines of sentences.
Right.
So you can quickly review your code. You can see that it's looking for the file path. It's asking for the CSV. It's then cleaning the data. It's looking for the correlation. It's then plotting the data. And I had it you can actually export to any tool you want. I use Power BI. So you could actually switch the input or output to Power BI. And you know, basically, code looks good. So I can then accept the code. So I hit tab to accept. It then brings it in, right? And so again, fairly mundane code. I think the biggest impact that you're going to see from having code gen at the edge is it's going to free your developers. It's going to free your engineers up for more creative work because they're not having to do this short mundane stuff.
Right.
After accepting, you can then quickly scan and Visual Studio actually makes it easy for you to find the errors, right? So this isn't perfect, let's be clear. There's a reason it is a co-pilot type code because you still have to be the pilot. But this makes it much easier to find the errors. I can drop these parentheses real quick in here, clean up the code, and then it's fully executable and ready to run. And so that's code gen at the edge. I mean, that's how easy it is.
And you mentioned security too. I think a lot of people didn't realize that, you know, there's a lot of coders and developers that did not want their code going out to the cloud because you've got proprietary data or secrets that you want to keep. So that's another reason that you'd want to have, you know, the NPU on a PC.
exactly right. That was the main purpose we actually implemented it here at Qualcomm. A, because we have access to the incredible architecture, but B, we didn't want our source code living in any of the hyperscalers libraries out there, right?
And Qualcomm's known for a lot of mobile chips. So is this something that, that could then be ported over to, or would it be a separate NPU? You'd probably make a little couple of tweaks to it, right?
Actually, it's super interesting. So probably you're wondering, where do I go? How do I actually implement this? We have the Qualcomm AI Hub. It actually already has 175 pre-optimized models that you can pull down today, and they automatically work with the NPU.
Yeah.
If you have your own model, you can actually import that into the Qualcomm AI Hub. As long as it's Onyx or PyTorch runtime environments, you can pull that in and optimize it directly for our NPU. Because Qualcomm leverages a common architecture across its chipsets, whether it's the PC, the mobile phone, a tablet, your XR device, your IoT devices, essentially you can take the same AI code set and run it across multiple devices across your enterprise.
Right.
And so this gives you a lot of efficiency as you're looking at what is my on-edge AI strategy look like, not only with the PC, but across your entire enterprise ecosystem.
Yeah, and again, the reason I asked that question was as AI was being put on these devices, there was always some doubt from the end user side of things, like why do I need an AI PC? But it was the same question for phones, like why do I need AI on phones? And a lot of the advertisements I've been seeing from the device makers has always been like, oh, well, you can draw a picture. It's like, but now you've explained it, like if you prefer doing all the stuff on your phone, you can then transfer it over a lot easier because it's the same architecture, right?
Yeah, and I think it ultimately comes down to the new experiences that you're able to create for AI. I'll put a teaser maybe for a future episode, right? So we've seen this in terms of being able to create code gen, but you could imagine a space, we build a lot of slides here at Qualcomm. Essentially, you can create the same thing where it would listen to our conversation. You could take a picture of a whiteboard, pull it down, and it would automatically generate the slides for your slide deck. So we're not ready yet to show that today, but would love to in a future episode with you.
All right, I've got a great idea for the phone.
Okay.
So you take that real-time language translation ability, and then you put it on a mobile phone, and then when I go to Paris, I can then talk in English and it shows up and,
It's possible.
It probably does it on this.
Yes.
But I want it in my hand or I want it in my ears, like into the ear pods.
Totally fair. Yeah. We've got Computex coming
I'm sure someone's working on it.
We used it last year. It was a great way to be basically in real time language assistant to be able to do real time translation. Fantastic.
All right. So if people interested in learning more about Qualcomm Snapdragon and all of the different benefits that it gives, where do they go?
If you're a large enterprise customer, contact your local Qualcomm rep. We've got now a fully built out Qualcomm enterprise team.
Yep.
If you're interested in exploring on your own, go explore our Qualcomm AI Hub, pull down some models, and you can get started today.
And the systems that will have the NPU on this, are they out now? Are they coming out really soon?
They've been out since June. So basically anything that's got a Snapdragon X in it, X Plus, X Elite. We're a bit unique in that we give this premium AI capability to every device in our stack, regardless of price point.
All right, Jeff Monday, again, thanks again for doing the demo.
Hey, Keith, thanks for having me.
That's all the time we have for today's episode. Be sure to like the video, subscribe to the channel, add any thoughts you have below. Join us every week for new episodes of Demo. I'm Keith Shaw. Thanks for watching.